Gentleman from Virginia, seek recognition.
As the member designated by Mr. Lowenthal pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lowenthal will vote yay on the veto override for HJ Res 76. And as the member designated by Mr. Liu of California pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Liu will vote yay on the veto override for House Joint Resolution 76. And as the member designated by Ms. Moore of Wisconsin pursuant to House Resolution 965, inform the House that Ms. Moore will vote yay on the veto override for House Joint Resolution 76.
Well
does the gentleman from the great state of Michigan seek recognition.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Mr. Lewis of Georgia, pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lewis will vote aye on the veto override for HJ Res 76.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Tennessee seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Mr. Lipinski pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lipinski will vote yay on the veto override for HJRES 76. Thank you.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Pennsylvania seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Ms. Lofgren pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House Ms. Lofgren will vote yay on the veto override of House HJRES 76. As the member designated by Mr. Garamendi pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Mr. Garamendi will vote yes.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from the state of New York seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mrs. Lowy pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Mrs. Lowy will vote yay on the veto override for HJRES 76. As the member designated by Mr. Serrano pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Mr. Serrano will vote yay on the veto override for HJRES 76.
For what purpose does the gentleman from the state of Pennsylvania seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as a member designated by Mr. Lawson of Florida, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lawson will vote yay.
Gentleman from the state of Arizona, seek recognition.
As a member designated by Representative Kirkpatrick, pursuant to H.R. 965, I inform the House that Representative Kirkpatrick will vote aye on the veto override for H.J. Resolution 76.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from the great state of Connecticut seek recognition?
As the member designated by Ms. Wilson, pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Wilson of Florida will vote yay on the veto override to H.J. Res 76.
It's Wilson. If the gentleman from Connecticut would again state her request.
As the member designated by Ms. Wilson, pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Wilson of Florida will vote aye on the veto override for H.J. Res 76.
I'm so glad you found your key.
For what purpose does the gentleman from the state of California seek recognition?
As a member designated by Mr. Desaigne of California, pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Desaigne will vote yay on the veto override for H.J.R.E.S. 76.
For what purpose does the gentleman from the state of California seek recognition?
As the member designated by Mr. Cardenas pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Cardenas will vote aye on the veto override of H.J.R.E.S. 76. As the member designated by Mr. Khanna pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Khanna will vote aye on the veto override of H.J.R.E.S. 76.
For what purpose does the gentleman from the state of New York seek recognition?
As the member designated by Mr. Deutsch of Florida pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Deutsch will vote yay on overriding President Trump's veto of H.J.R.E.S. 76.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from the state of California seek recognition?
Okay. As the member designated by Ms. Sanchez pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Sanchez will vote aye on the veto override for H.J. Resolution 76.
I inform the House that Ms. Frankel will vote yay on the veto override for H.J. Res 76. As the member designated by Representative Shelley Pingree pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Ms. Pingree will vote yea on the veto override for HJ Res 76.
For what purpose does the distinguished chair of the Rules Committee, the gentleman from the state of Massachusetts, seek recognition?
As the member designated by Mr. Welsh of Vermont, pursuant to HRES 965, I will inform the House that Mr. Welsh will vote aye on the veto override for HJ Res 76.
For what purpose does the prestigious chairman of the Energy and Commerce Committee, the gentleman from the state of New Jersey, seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Ms. Bonnie Watson Coleman, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Watson Coleman will vote aye on the veto override.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from the state of Pennsylvania seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Ms. Speer, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Speer will vote yea on the veto override for HJ Resolution 76.
Does the gentleman from the state of California seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As member designated by Congressmember Grace Napolitano, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Congressmember Napolitano would vote aye on the veto override of House Resolution SJ Res 76. Thank you.
For what purpose does the gentleman from the state of Massachusetts seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by the Honorable James Langevin, the gentleman from Rhode Island, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Langevin will vote yes on overriding President Trump's veto of House Resolution 76. Thank you.
For what purpose does the distinguished chairman of the House Democratic Caucus, the gentleman from Brooklyn, seek recognition?
Thank the distinguished gentleman from Colorado. As the member designated by Chairwoman Eddie Bernice Johnson, pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Chairwoman Johnson will vote aye on the veto override for HJ Res 76.
Figured I got it. For what purpose is the gentleman from the state of Maryland seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Ms. Axne of Iowa, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Axne will vote aye on the veto override for House Resolution 76.
Woman from Florida. For what purpose does the gentleman from Florida seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mr. Payne of New Jersey, pursuant to HRES 965, I inform the House that Mr. Payne will vote yea on the veto override for HJ Res 76.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from the state of Nevada seek recognition?
Thank you. As the member designated by Mr. Engel, pursuant to House Res 965, I inform the House that Mr. Engel will vote yea on the veto override for HJ Res 76.
On this vote, the yeas are 238 and the nays are 173. Two-thirds not being in the affirmative, the veto of the president is sustained and the joint resolution is rejected. The veto message and the joint resolution are referred to the Committee on Education and Labor. The clerk will notify the Senate of the action of the House. There you go.
Pursuant to Clause 8 of Rule 20, the unfinished business is the question on agreeing to the motion to recommit on H.R. 51 offered by the gentleman from Pennsylvania, Mr. Keller, on which the yeas and nays were ordered. The clerk will redesignate the motion.
Motion to recommit on H.R. 51 offered by Mr. Keller of Pennsylvania.
The question is on agreeing to the motion to recommit. Members will record their votes by electronic device. That's right. We got over there. For what purpose does the gentleman from Pennsylvania rise?
Thank you. Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Ms. Lofgren pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Lofgren will vote nay on the motion to recommit. As the member designated by Mr. Garamendi pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Garamendi will vote no on the motion to recommit.
Thank you, sir.
Does the gentleman from California seek recognition?
As the member designated by Mr. Khanna, pursuant to H. Res. 965, informed the House that Mr. Khanna will vote nay on the motion to recommit. As the member designated by Mr. Cardenas, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I informed the House that Mr. Cardenas will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Maryland seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Ms. Axne of Iowa, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Axne will be voting nay on the motion to recommit. She'll be voting nay.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Virginia seek recognition?
As the member designated by Ms. Moore, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Moore will vote nay on the motion to recommit. And as the member designated by Mr. Liu, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Liu will vote nay on the motion to recommit. And as the member designated by Mr. Lowenthal, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lowenthal will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Tennessee rise?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Mr. Lipinski, pursuant to H.R.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lipinski will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentlelady from Connecticut seek recognition?
As the member designated by Ms. Wilson, pursuant to H.R.S. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Wilson of Florida will vote no on the motion to recommit.
Purpose does the gentlewoman from New York rise?
As a member designated by Mrs. Lowy, pursuant to H.R.S. 965, I inform the House that Mrs. Lowy will vote nay on the motion to recommit. As a member designated by Mr. Serrano, pursuant to H.R.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Serrano will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
What purpose does the gentleman from Pennsylvania seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mr. Lawson of Florida, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lawson votes nay.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from California seek recognition?
As a member designated by Ms. Sanchez pursuant to H Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Sanchez will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Massachusetts seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by the Honorable James Langevin of Rhode Island, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Langevin will vote no on the motion to recommit of H.R. 51. Thank you.
For what purpose does the gentleman from California seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as member designated by Congressmember Grace Napolitano, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Congressmember Napolitano will be voting nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Michigan seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mr. Lewis of Georgia, pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lewis will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Massachusetts seek recognition?
As a member designated by Mr. Welsh of Vermont, pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Welsh will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentleman from New York seek recognition?
As the member designated by Chairwoman Eddie Bernice Johnson pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Chairwoman Johnson will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
Does the gentleman from Arizona seek recognition?
As a member designated by Representative Kirkpatrick, pursuant to H.R. 965, I inform the House that Representative Kirkpatrick will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from California seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as a member designated by Mr. Desaunier, pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Desaunier will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
Does the gentlewoman from Pennsylvania seek recognition?
As the member designated by Ms. Spear, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Spear will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from Florida seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mr. Payne of New Jersey, pursuant to H.Res. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Payne will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from Nevada seek recognition?
As a member designated by Mr. Engel, pursuant to House Res 965, I inform the House that Mr. Engel will vote no on the motion to recommit.
New Hampshire seek recognition.
As the member designated by Representative Lois Frankel, pursuant to H.Res. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Frankel will vote nay on the motion to recommit. As the member designated by Representative Shelley Pingree, pursuant to H.Res. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Pingree will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from New York seek recognition?
As the member designated by Mr. Deutsch of Florida, pursuant to H.Res. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Deutsch will vote nay on the motion to recommit.
Purpose does the gentleman from New Jersey seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Ms. Bonnie Watson Coleman, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Watson Coleman will vote no.
This vote, the yeas are 182 and the nays are 227. The motion is not adopted. The question is on passage of the bill. Those in favor say aye. Those opposed say no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it.
Speaker, Mr. Speaker.
For what purpose does the gentleman from
Georgia
seek
recognition? Request the yeas and nays.
Pursuant to Section 3 of House Resolution 965, the yeas and nays are ordered. Members will record their votes by electronic device. For what purpose does the gentleman from Maryland seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Ms. Axne of Iowa pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Axne will vote aye on H.R. 51, the Washington, D.C. Admission Act.
Gentlewoman from New York, seek recognition.
Aided by Mr. Deutsch of Florida, pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Deutsch will vote yea on H.R. 51.
Does the gentlewoman from New Hampshire seek recognition?
1 second.
As the member designated by Representative Lois Frankel pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Frankel will vote yea on H.R. 51. As the member designated by Representative Shelley Pingree pursuant to H.R.E.S. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Pingree will vote yea on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Pennsylvania seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mr. Lawson of Florida, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lawson will vote yes.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from Pennsylvania seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Ms. Speer pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Speer will vote yea on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentleman from California seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as member designated by Congressmember Grace Napolitano pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Congressmember Napolitano will vote yea on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Massachusetts seek recognition?
Good afternoon, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by the Honorable James Langevin of Rhode Island, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I'd like to inform the House that Mr. Langevin will vote yes on final passage of H.R. 51. Thank you.
For what purpose does the gentleman from New Jersey seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Ms. Bonnie Watson Coleman, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Watson Coleman will vote aye.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Michigan seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mr. Lewis of Georgia, pursuant to H.R.S. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lewis will vote aye on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from California seek recognition?
As the member designated by Ms. Sanchez, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Ms. Sanchez will vote aye on H.R. 51.
I was going to say. Does the gentleman from Virginia seek recognition?
As the member designated by Mr. Liu of California, pursuant to House Resolution 965, inform the House that Mr. Liu will vote yay on H.R. 51. And as the member designated by Ms. Moore of Wisconsin, pursuant to House Resolution 965, inform the House that Ms. Moore will vote yay on H.R. 51. And as the member designated by Mr. Lowenthal of California, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lowenthal will vote yay on H.R. 51.
Have a nice Speaker of the House is voting. For what purpose does the gentlewoman from Florida seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as the member designated by Mr. Payne of New Jersey, pursuant to H.R. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Payne will vote yay on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentleman from California seek recognition?
As the member designated by Mr. Karnos pursuant to H.R. 965, I will inform the House that Mr. Karnos will vote aye on H.R. 51. As the member designated by Mr. Khanna pursuant to H.R. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Khanna will vote aye on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentleman from New York seek recognition?
As the member designated by Chairwoman Eddie Bernice Johnson, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Chairwoman Johnson will vote aye on H.R. 51.
Does the gentleman from Tennessee seek recognition?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Mr. Lipinski, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Lipinski will vote yea on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from California seek recognition?
Mr. Speaker, as a member designated by Mr. Desaunier, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Desaunier will vote yea on H.R. 51.
We were doing such blue ribbon work, and then it
Okay. What purpose should the gentlewoman from New York rise?
As the member designated by Mrs. Lowy, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Mrs. Lowy will vote yay on H.R. 51. As the member designated by Mr. Serrano, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Serrano will vote yay on H.R. 51.
What purpose does the gentleman from New Mexico rise?
I'm not from
what
New Mexico.
What purpose does the gentleman rise?
As the member designated
from Arizona.
Member designated by Representative Kirkpatrick pursuant to H.R. 965, I inform the House that Representative Kirkpatrick will vote aye on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentleman from Pennsylvania rise?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As the member designated by Ms. Lofgren of California, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Lofgren will vote yay on H.R. 51. As the member designated by Mr. Garamendi of California, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Mr. Garamendi will vote yay on H.R. 51.
Member designated by Mr. Welsh of Vermont, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I will inform the House that Mr. Welsh will vote aye on H.R. 51.
For what purpose does the gentlewoman from Connecticut rise?
As the member designated by Ms. Wilson, pursuant to H. Res. 965, I inform the House that Ms. Wilson of Florida will vote yea on H.R. 51.
We have. For purposes of the gentlewoman from Nevada, rise.
Thank you. As the member designated by Mr. Engel, pursuant to House Resolution 965, I inform the House that Mr. Engel will vote yes on H.R. 51.
32 votes. Members voted. There being 232 votes in the affirmative, 180 votes in the negative, the District of Columbia Statehood Bill, H.R. 51, is passed without objection. Motion to reconsider is laid upon the table.
Does the gentlewoman from California rise?
Madam Speaker, I ask unanimous consent to take from the Speaker's table Senate Concurrent Resolution 38 and ask for its immediate consideration in the House.
The clerk will report the title of the Concurrent Resolution.
Senate Concurrent Resolution 38, Concurrent Resolution to establish the Joint Congressional Committee on Inaugural Ceremonies for the inauguration of the President-elect and Vice President-elect of the United States on January 20th, 2021.
Is there objection to the consideration of the concurrent resolution? Without objection, the concurrent resolution is agreed to and the motion to reconsider is laid on the table. Pursuant to Clause 12A of Rule 1, the Chair declares the House in recess for a period less than 15 minutes. Results will be in order. For what purpose does the gentleman from Georgia arise?
Madam Speaker, I ask unanimous consent to speak out of order for the purpose of inquiring to the majority leader the schedule for the week to come.
Without objection.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I ask unanimous consent to revise and extend my remarks.
Without objection.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I yield to my friend from Maryland, the majority leader.
I thank the gentleman from Georgia, for yielding. Madam Speaker, on Monday, the House will meet at 9 a.m. for morning hour debate. I would repeat that because it's unusual. On Monday, we're meeting at 9 a.m. For morning hour debate and 10 a.m. for legislative business, with votes expected to occur as early as 2:30 p.m. On Tuesday and Wednesday, the House will meet at 9 a.m. for morning hour debate and 10 a.m. for legislative business. On Thursday, the House will meet at 9 a.m. for legislative business. The House will consider H.R. 1425, Patient Protection and Affordable Care Enhancement Act. This bill will significantly increase the ACA's affordability, subsidies, lower prescription drug prices, expand coverage, and crack down on junk plans, while strengthening protections for people with pre-existing conditions and addressing racial health disparities. The House will also consider, Madam Speaker, H.R. 7301, which is the Emergency Housing Protection and Relief Act of 2020. This bill would authorize nearly $200 billion for the dire housing needs arising due to the COVID-19 pandemic. H.R. 7301, which was included in the HEROES Act, would help renters and homeowners by extending the eviction and foreclosure moratoria, provide $100 billion for emergency rental assistance, and $75 billion for homeowners assistance to cover mortgage, property tax, utilities, and more than $11 billion for homeless assistance programs. I would again reiterate that that bill passed as a part of the HEROES Act, and which is now pending in the Senate. Lastly, the House will consider H.R. 2, Moving Forward Act. This bill would invest more than $1.5 trillion in modern, sustainable infrastructure while creating millions of good-paying jobs, combating the climate crisis, and addressing disparities in urban, suburban, and rural communities. The bill includes a five-year reauthorization of the Surface Transportation Program, invests in schools with the Reopen and Rebuild America Schools Act, invests over $100 billion in our nation's affordable housing infrastructure, delivers affordable high-speed broadband, internet access to all parts of the country, and promotes new, clean, renewable energy infrastructure. We expect at that point in time to be out on Thursday for the July 4th break, and I would tell the House that the 2 weeks that will follow the July 4th weekend will be reserved, as were the first weeks in June, for committees to do their work, in particular the National Defense Authorization Act being considered by the House Armed Services Committee. That bill is obviously a very lengthy, composes half, a little more than half of the discretionary spending, and we expect the committee to need substantial time to mark up that bill. In addition, the Appropriations Committee will be marking up its 12 bills for consideration by the House. And in the last 2 weeks, we will be taking the products that will not be limited to the NDAA and the appropriation bills, but will be primarily taking up the time with other legislation that will be promoted and sent to the floor for consideration by the committees. And I yield back my time.
Thank you, and I very much appreciate that update. And question, does the gentleman expect to consider amendments to H.R. 2 on the transportation bill on the floor next week?
Yes, we are. I talked to Mr. McCarthy with the gentleman yield.
Yes.
I talked to Mr. McCarthy yesterday. Obviously, because of the time frame that the COVID-19 health strictures have imposed upon us, it takes a long time to vote on amendments. So rather than consider amendments individually, the leader and I talked about having amendments either in manager's amendments or in amendments which have a lot of individual amendments within them, and they will be considered in gross. So that there may well be a lot of amendments, but we hope to hold the votes down to a manageable level. As you know, votes have been taking about an hour, so that every amendment, if we took every amendment seriatim, frankly, we wouldn't finish until September. So we're trying to manage that, and we're working with the minority leader. I yield back.
Thank you. Well, I'm happy to hear that, but it seems kind of odd that this week, when we were considering the police reform bill, there were no amendment considerations. And I believe the majority leader, Madam Speaker, said on the floor that we have constraints on amendments because of the coronavirus. So I ask, if there were amendment constraints this week, do those same constraints exist next week?
No, it turns out that we consider the bill in the House the same way the minority leader wanted to consider the majority leader of the Senate wanted to consider the Scott bill or the Republican policing bill. So both houses wanted to consider them apparently in the same way.
Well, I certainly appreciate that, but I was a little disappointed this week in the fact that I thought we had a chance to make the bill better, the police reform bill. It was a genuine effort on both sides of the aisle to have this discussion. But once again, you know, the Republican voice was left out. And there were really some really good amendments and ideas from our side that simply did not gain consideration on the floor, and they should have. One such example was the Klein Amendment that really would have discouraged collective bargaining agreements with organizations that really kind of had poor officer disciplinary tactics, something that really could have fundamentally changed how departments operate in big cities. But anyway, it's a disappointment. Hate that we did not get to do that.
Will the gentleman yield?
For just a minute, yes.
Thank you. We are hopeful that the Senate will pass a bill. I know that my friend will say, well, yes, but it's the Democrats that stopped the bill. Let me tell you, I genuinely hope that we have a bill passed by the Senate, that we go to conference, and that we adopt a bill which can garner the support of the majority of the House and the Senate and can be signed by the President of the United States. As I said on the floor when we considered the bill, Karen Bass and the Congressional Black Caucus and those of us who strongly supported the bill, we don't want to send a message, we want to make a difference. And to the extent that making a difference requires us to have agreement between the two parties, I'm hopeful we will get to that objective.
Well, claiming my time, those words are fine now, but when we talk about having agreement and talk about having those discussions, Madam Speaker, clearly the committee and this body should be considering it as an entire body. The opportunity for us to consider those amendments here on the floor of the House is really important. But we understand that the minority in the Senate blocked a debate and continuation of Senator Scott's bill, which was quite candidly an excellent piece of legislation. And if anyone has not seen his remarks on the Senate floor in his speech, I would highly encourage you to do it. But that was a disappointment. But then to hear the majority leader say that we're going to eliminate debate in this House simply to do it in conference, I think we deserve a better opportunity than that. But I understand you're in the majority and that's the way that y'all have chosen to do that. But hopefully we can get to that point where we can have those honest debates right here on the House floor.
Will the gentleman yield?
For just a minute.
The gentleman will surely note that when his party was in power and was scheduling bills, you had the most closed rules of any Congress in the history of the Congress. I yield back.
Seems to me that I voted on a lot more amendments last year than I have this year.
We probably did have
more closed bills, but we seem to have a lot more legislative activity. We seem to be a lot more productive. But anyway, so, Mr. Speaker, another thing that is concerning to us is that we're disappointed about what's transpired in the House over the recent weeks. And, you know, for the first time in 230 years, members elect to come to D.C. and represent their constituents, but they no longer need to do that. Instead, they can now turn their voting cards over to another member, including Speaker Pelosi or any other member, and have them vote in their place using this new proxy voting scheme. And one thing that I'm thankful for is that the covered period for this laid out by the Speaker comes to an end July the 4th, and we look forward to seeing all of the members come back to do their jobs. And since many states are fully reopened, and even here in D.C., Phase 2 reopen is in its place, and you can go to restaurants and gyms. Matter of fact, we can even now go to the house gym again. And most employees are returning to work. With that said, I'd like to confirm with the gentleman that he does not plan to extend the July 4th covered period and continue this absurd proxy voting scheme.
First of all, of course, I reject emphatically the premise that this is absurd. As the gentleman knows, there were some 70 some weeks ago who cast their vote. There were 30 today. They cast their votes because they were concerned about their health or families to whom they would return health. And I think the gentleman probably has been reading as well and maybe listening to the extraordinary spike in cases that have been identified and the concern that the hospital beds will be overrun. We will end this when the medical community, not somebody who has no medical knowledge and very little command of the facts, tells us time to get together again. And when he told people to do that, they did get together, 10 of whom apparently work for the White House who've gotten infected, and frankly, spikes in Florida, in Texas, in Arizona, and yes, even in California, and some other states as well, including Arkansas. Now, I'm not sure exactly what the figures are in your state, but Mr. Speaker, Madam Speaker, I believe that we're going to continue to be concerned about the health of the members, the health of the staff, the health of the people who cover us on behalf of the American people. So I can't tell you whether it's going to end, because I can't tell you when the pandemic is going to end. I can't tell you when the spike in numbers of people who are getting sick or people who are dying are going to end. But I can tell you that we will be very sensitive to the risks, and we will act accordingly.
Well, certainly we want to be safe and thoughtful about what we do. But I think America, I think we've done an excellent job of what we set out to do, which is not to stop the spread of this virus, but it was to slow the spread of the virus. Not a single one of us, not a single person in America wanted to see one of our fellow Americans suffer because there was not room for them in a healthcare facility where they needed it. And I think that we've done that. And I think America has shown that they've had the discipline to stay at home and to bend the infection rate curve down. So surely there will be more Americans that contract COVID. But thank goodness that our healthcare system is strong enough and intact that we have the capacity to take care of the most vulnerable.